And Rob, those of us who followed this story from the very beginning know how hard the Haitians worked to make this happen. They didn't quit. They didn't give up. So as exciting as it was to see their girls walk into their new home, they remind us that the fight for the orphans is far from over. Two weeks ago, time was running out.
It's just bleak down there.
A family and a country were watching.
Kirsten Heaton says it's getting harder to communicate with the orphanage where her loved ones, Batania and Danette, are being cared for.
And waiting.
They're just babies, you know. We're desperately trying to get them home.
Yet nearly 2 weeks later came the plane to Pittsburgh. Then the 50-plus orphans on board. Not long after that, the last leg of a journey.
Finally, we made it!
That took more than 4 years to finish.
You're here! You're home!
In public, the excitement for Batania and Danette was overwhelming. But in private, home at last.
Come on in. Go on up. Go up the stairs.
Excitement grows with each step.
Somebody made you a sign.
Aww.
For the first time, a 7-year-old sees a new life that's been no more than a dream. This, as a 2-year-old.
That's Tigger.
Oh. Meets a new set of challenges.
When is he downstairs?
Kristen Heaton introduced her daughters to what will soon become status quo. For these girls, fireplaces are foreign.
Not like the fires in Haiti that you have to start, huh?
Pool tables, perplexing.
Uh-oh.
Everything that most of us take for granted is a mystery for girls who've lived near misery ever since they were born.
Try it. No, it's coffee.
The Heaton girls beat the clock to survive.
Gotta stand up.
You can take it down.
There you go. Go get her.
Hi, come on. Let's go eat and go to bed.
But for this now family of six near Lincoln.
The battle for the orphan is far from over all over the world.
A struggle to save those who can't save themselves is no longer a goal. It's a conviction.
It's actually just begun. I'm afraid that if we don't fight and we don't fight fast, these kids are not going to survive.
And a very special thanks to the Heaton family for allowing us and the New York Times to be there at their home Friday night. As it stands, Batania has now been formally adopted. Danette is still here on refugee status, waiting for more paperwork to go through.
Still, as the family said, though, Ryan, fight is far from over.
Oh, absolutely. There are hundreds of thousands of orphans, not only in Haiti out there, but around the world.
But the Heatons, a little step at a time. This is great.
Absolutely.
Thanks, Ryan.